Hello everyone, my name is John Reed and I'm one of the engineers that works on Google Web Designer. Today I'd like to demonstrate the new Ad Validator that we added to this release. The Ad Validator runs some simple tests on your file and displays the results for you if there are any problems. The tests that it runs are based on the ad network that you've chosen to use. So if you're working in a
display and video 360
ad, it will run tests that are appropriate for that ad. And if you're working in an AdMob ad, it'll run tests appropriate for an AdMob ad and so forth. I'm going to go ahead and open up a file here so you can see what it looks like. It's a new panel over on the side here, and you can see it's divided into two sections. On the top, we have some basic file information. It tells you what environment you're working in. In this case, we're working on Google Ads, and it gives you your initial load size and total sizes. These are the initial load sizes, just the size of the HTML file, and the total size is the HTML file plus any assets you've added to the project. And before, this information was just displayed in the publish dialog, but we've moved it out here into the panel where it's easier to see. You can see it also gives you a countdown to your size limit, if there's a size limit on the network that you're working on. In case Google Ads, they have 150K size limit, and so we have plenty of space left for that. Down below are the results of the tests that it's running. You can see here it tells you that the file size is under the size limit, which is good. The file name length is under the size limit.
Google Ads
limits file names for zip files to 30 characters. And if you go over that, it'll let you know. And the HTML is well-formed. We run a very basic HTML test that determines that you have the right tags and stuff like that. It's very simple. The best way to demonstrate this is to go ahead and do something that generates a problem. You can see here this asset that we have in the asset library. Is very large. If we add this to the project, it's going to be well over the 150K size limit. So let me go ahead and do that. You'll see that it's added a warning that we're over the file size limit, and up here the size has updated to show that you have no more left to your size limit and so forth. So that's how it displays that. And we can go ahead and fix that. I'm just going to swap out the image. And you can see once you've swapped the image, it updates immediately. So now the file size is under limit, and you can see how much you have left to do your stuff. That actually works for just about anything that you want to do. So if we add, for example, an image button, you can see it updates immediately here to say image button, image is missing for image button. What it's referring to are the over are the various state images for image button. So here you can see we have an up image, over image, and down image. We have to have one for each of these. You can see once we've added these three to the image button, it does show us that the images are found for all image button states, but because we've chosen that large file, once again we're over our file size limit. Another thing to be aware of is that in addition to showing things here in the Ad Validator panel, when you go to publish your document, we'll also show the same information. So if you take a look here, you can see that we show the results of your validation checks, and we show anything that's having a problem. So this gives you the ability to see at your last step before you publish that there are problems, and you can go back in and fix them. So in this case, we can just delete that. You can see everything's fine, and when we go back into publish, you can see we've passed all of our checks. That wraps it up for this feature. Please take a look at our other videos for our other new features.